one worry I have with Fridays for Futures is I've seen and heard a kind of depoliticization. In a way, or refusal to accept politicization. In Belgium, they are working with the extreme right and the left in the parliaments, and they're saying, you know, climate change affects everyone. We need to work with everyone. That's exactly what the elite are doing. You know, the elite are saying, yeah, we need to work with everyone. We need to work with corporations, and we need to work with citizens, and we need to work with government. Imagining everyone is equal, and of course, we know that's not the case. And I think we need to point to the enemy very clearly. So I think that's, for me, a challenge in Fridays for the Futures. And I think it's also we're in a moment of winning, and the moments of winning are always the most dangerous moments, actually. You know, I've been doing this stuff for 25 years. You know, 25 years ago, you would not get 6,000 people shutting down a coal mine. We'd be 20. And you'd have to argue with people that climate change existed. You know, I mean, we're in another space now, and that's amazing, but it's also very dangerous. And my big fear, and maybe we'll kind of understand, is the rise of eco-fascism and authoritarian, green authoritarianism. And I think an urgency also pushes that. Speaking too much of collapse, an urgency is an open door to that. And your government, with their slogan, protecting the climate and protecting the borders, could well be a very dark shadow for a future if we're not very careful about really politicizing the climate justice issue.
You said it's dangerous for movements if they're successful. At the point of success, did I get it right? Do you want to elaborate a bit more? Why?
Because it's the moment where you're most swallowed and digested. You know, and suddenly the system goes, fuck, yeah, okay, there's this huge movement. Either we resist it or we swallow and digest it. And that's what's happening right now. You know, when you see, you know, the discourse at Davos this year, or which, you know, 7 years ago, you imagine that kind of discourse at Davos, never. So I think it's the moment where all these ideas become integrated and the system tries to digest them and tries to make, you know, in a capitalist system, tries to make money with them. And in the end, we only win these struggles because we cost them money. You know, they're not going to stop digging coal because they, in the Rhineland, because they think they have some moral vision and go, oh yeah, fuck, we're destroying life on Earth, we better stop. They'll stop the coal because it's going to cost them too much money to dig it out, because people are resisting and whatever, you know. So so that's the danger, is this moment of being digested and having turning out in something that you didn't imagine.